President Trump taking drastic steps in the face of a growing public health crisis. What is the White House doing to contain the coronavirus outbreak? Joining us now is Vice President Mike Pence. He is leading the federal government's coronavirus response. Mr. Vice President, we are really grateful to have you here with us this morning.
Thanks, Allison.
Our viewers and so many Americans have questions. And so forgive me if I move us along quickly through this interview,
please.
Because I want us to cover a lot of ground.
You bet.
Okay, thank you. So President Trump's speech last night, after he talked about the travel ban from Europe, or travel restrictions, I guess I should say, from Europe, and the handling of cargo shipments, two clarifications basically had to be issued within the space of an hour. One from DHS saying the travel restrictions do not apply to all travel. And then the president himself tweeted he didn't mean cargo. So why the confusion?
I don't think there was confusion. The president took another historic step, just like he did in January with China, to suspend all travel from Europe, Allison, for the next 30 days, because we've recognized, our health experts tracking global data, that the epicenter of the coronavirus has shifted from China and South Korea to Europe. 2 weeks ago, there were roughly 500 coronavirus cases in Italy. There's 12,000 as of today, 1,000 in Germany yesterday, 1,000 in France. And so the health team came into the Oval Office, presented that to the president, and he made the decision on the spot after hearing from all sides that the best thing we could do was suspend all travel. And Americans coming home will be funneled through 13 different airports. They'll be screened, and then we're going to ask every American and legal resident returning to the United States to self-quarantine for 14 days.
That's helpful information.
This is a part of our strategy. You combine that with what we're doing in communities where, like Washington State and California and New York, where we have what's called community spread.
Yeah.
CDC issued tough new guidance to those states about mitigation strategies. And the overall recommendation to Americans to use common sense, practice good hygiene, and keep a special eye on seniors with chronic underlying health conditions.
And
it's all part of the president's strategy
to
protect the American people from the coronavirus.
And I do want to get to those specific things in a moment. But about those travel restrictions, the clarification was that it's not all travel. It's not, as you say, some people, Americans coming back from Europe. Here, though, is what Tom Bossert, your former Homeland Security advisor up until 2018, said about these kinds of travel restrictions. He tweeted this last night. There's little value to European travel restrictions, poor use of time and energy. Earlier, yes, now travel restrictions, screening are less useful. We have nearly as much disease here in the US as the countries in Europe. We must focus on layered community mitigation measures now, exclamation point. Is he wrong?
Well, I think our health experts would disagree very strongly with the view that the action the president took last night with Europe was not called for. The truth is, we learned yesterday 70% of all the new cases for coronavirus in the world happened in Europe. And probably most concerning to the president was, as of yesterday, when we looked at 35 states on the map where we had coronavirus cases, fully 30 of those cases could be traced to contacts in Europe. And so the president took the action. But to the point, to the point of the comment, we're not doing a travel ban as our strategy. The suspending all travel for 30 days from Europe is a part of the strategy. The other part is an aggressive mitigation strategy. I spoke to the governors of New York, Washington State, and California yesterday. CDC issued strong guidance to those areas where we have community spread.
Yeah.
We've flowed resources, we've flowed support to those areas. And so it's a combination of strategies that the president has employed here.
Yeah.
As he says, it's all hands on deck, a whole of government approach. but it's also a whole of America approach. We've literally been meeting with industry leaders in one relevant industry after another to ensure that the full resources of America are being
understood.
Brought to bear.
But I do want to ask you about testing, because that there's been so much confusion about this. Last night, the president said testing and testing capabilities are expanding rapidly day by day. We are moving very quickly. But the numbers on the CDC, the official government website, tell a different story. The numbers suggest that the most testing was done March 5th. That was from U.S. public health labs and CDC labs. The numbers were more than 1,100. Then, if you move forward, each day it gets a little bit less until on March 10th, CDC labs, zero are the numbers listed, and only eight at public health labs. So why are the number of tests going down?
Well, I don't believe they are, Allison. One of the things that we're actually working on is a central reporting website where every state in the country and territory can let CDC and the American people know the number of tests.
But you're saying this website, these numbers are wrong.
Your viewers should be encouraged that every state laboratory in America can conduct coronavirus tests today. We've also cleared out regulatory barriers to university hospitals and laboratories to be able to conduct tests. And I want to commend the University of Washington for the extraordinary work they're doing expanding tests to the people impacted in Washington State.
Yes.
We're also working with commercial laboratories. The president brought in companies like Quest and LabCorp last week. And literally by the day, this weekend, both of those companies had approved new tests that are going to market. Literally by the day, we're continuing to expand, because it's going to be ultimately, it's going to be the commercial laboratories that have the capacity to get tests all over the country.
That's fair. So if you're saying that the CDC website numbers are wrong, how many tests have been conducted in the U.S.?
I'm not saying they're wrong, Allison. I'm saying that they may not be complete, because we don't necessarily collect today all the information from state laboratories about the tests that are being done.
That's the same thing virtually.
Well, as I said, our team is working now to make sure that we have a central reporting location, because state labs are doing tests all over the country, even as we speak.
That's good to know. But how many tests would you say have been done?
Well, I would leave that to the experts. But I would say to you, as a benefit to your viewers, anyone who's looking on today who might be concerned that they were exposed to coronavirus or have symptoms should call their doctor. Their doctor, with any question, can call their state laboratory and be able to find out how they can have a test process.
But this is important, Mr. Vice President.
That's going to take a few more days to get out to the broader public. The commercial labs in this country, we're confident, are going to be able to produce and distribute on a wide range across the country in the days ahead.
Okay.
And not the weeks ahead, the days ahead, all across this country.
Okay, because that doesn't seem to be the case right now. I mean, in all due respect, there are all sorts of anecdotal stories, as well as op-eds, articles, about people who had symptoms, went to their primary care physician, were told to go to the emergency room, and could not get a test. So that's not happening yet today.
Well, we think it's important that that last week we changed the criteria for testing. I spoke to Governor Jay Inslee, and there was some concern that the guidance that doctors had at the time was if you were only mildly symptomatic, it did not indicate that a test was appropriate. We changed that, and that's when the president said that anyone who wanted a test could have one on a doctor's orders. There's no barrier to that now.
But make no mistake
about it, we're making steady progress.
Yeah.
We made changes at the FDA in January at the president's direction. And the American people can be confident we're going to continue to roll out the test. And maybe most significant on that score is that the president brought health insurance companies in last week, and they all agreed to waive the copays on testing. We expanded testing to Medicare and Medicaid patients, and we also expanded coverage for treatment and health insurance companies expanded coverage for
treatment. That's very good to know.
We don't want anybody to avoid having a test because they're concerned financially.
Understood. But just one last question about the testing, Mr. Vice President. Mm-hmm. Sure. If you don't know how many tests have been done in the country, how can you know where the clusters of the outbreak are? And isn't that what is most important in terms of, for instance, here in New Rochelle, where there's a containment zone? If you don't know where the clusters are, how can we effectively combat this?
Well, we know precisely where the clusters are today with regard to Washington State, portions of California, and New York. And yesterday, the CDC issued very strong guidance about community activities, social distancing, schools, nursing homes, and the like for those areas. Because what we've done with the testing so far is we've really flowed those resources into areas where we have what's known as community spread. But in terms of making the test broadly available all across the country, we're working on that. The commercial labs are making that possible. I want your viewers to know we're making great progress. But in the areas where people have had concerns, where they've been exposed to coronavirus, in Washington State, California, and New York, we've spun up the testing. We've gotten a lot of people tested.
Okay.
And I want people to know that the risk to contracting the coronavirus, according to all of our experts, for the average American remains low.
Okay.
Most people that contracted Allison will have flu-like symptoms and recover. But the most important message to anyone looking on here today on CNN is, we do know that the coronavirus represents a unique threat to seniors with serious chronic underlying health conditions.
Yes.
It's the reason why we raised guidelines at nursing homes last week. It's the reason why the president said last night that people should avoid visiting nursing homes unless absolutely necessary. That every American with a senior with a chronic underlying condition needs to practice good hygiene around them and make sure that we're looking after our most vulnerable.
Absolutely. And very quickly, yes or no, are you still shaking hands?
I'm still shaking hands here at the White House. I'm also washing my hands very regularly through the day. And it's one of the common sense practices that Americans can engage in.
Understood.
Is wash your hands regularly, clean those often used surfaces. Yep. I mean, we're all in this together, and if the American people continue to practice good common sense practices, we'll focus resources on communities that have been impacted with the new suspension of travel from Europe, the continuing suspension of travel from China. We're going to work our hearts out to keep the number of people exposed and contracting this disease low, and together, I know we'll get through this.